Glorious morning for some football. Nick, you gonna fetch me some lemonade?
Sorry, Dad, we got nothing.
And find something that'll work. We ain't got all day.
Guys, this is Greg, the first camera person. A group of superheroes has agreed to let us film their lives. Let's check in with them now.
My name is Nicholas Walton, and I'm a full-time superhero, which is kind of a hard job. It definitely has its highs and lows. One time, I remember I was walking down the street, and some guy threw a tomato at me. I mean, that's insane.
Hey, you suck.
Hey! Hey!
And that's when I forgot my capsule.
Oh!
Wow, that was embarrassing. My capsule, which controls my superpowers, helps me out most of the time. But not that time.
scary images earlier. My name is Julie Walton, and I'm Nick's wife. Normally I'd be at work right now, but since I don't have a job, I can't. But there's nothing that I love more than my morning cup of coffee. I just need to go and get some milk for it.
Thomas! That is gross and undignified! Ugh.
Kids.
Good morning, guys! How did everybody sleep? I think it's time for a family meeting, but first, let me get my Cheerios. Okay, folks, I guess it's time to have our meeting. The first order of business is budgeting.
We have spent a lot of money over the last couple of months. For example, $100 on dry cleaning, give me a break. And Tom here had to use our credit card for his school books.
I think the best option is for all of us to get jobs, and that includes you, Tom. Even with Julie and I getting jobs, money will still be tight.
But I thought we had jobs. I thought we were superheroes.
Good point, Tom. However, your mom and I have been thinking. Maybe it's time that we retire. However, Tom, I've not told you this before, and I'm sorry to have to do it, but our capsules were stolen.
Oh no.
Our cameras were off, and we don't know who did it. I went to the police, and they were no help at all. So as a result, our powers have been severely limited.
No! But I won't get any girls.
Sometimes I wonder about him. So Mom's going back to her old job as a filmmaker. I got a job at Starbucks, and I got you a great job at the Apple Store. Starts next week. So I guess we can all agree that that went well. Yeah! Well, off to Starbucks. First day at work. Bye, son.
Bye, Dad.
You're 5 minutes late, mister. Are you deaf? Because I don't hear any words coming out of your mouth.
Sorry, ma'am. I didn't know.
Anyway, let me show you how to work. Because obviously you don't know how to. So the name's Nick, right?
Yeah, huh?
Okay. I guess I could sum it up in a few words. No swearing, no workplace affairs, and no drugs. And I'm watching you. Welcome to Starbucks.
Thanks. Anything you want to order, kid?
Hey, Mr. Cool Guy. If you're not going to order something, then just leave.
Cemetery.
Yeah, Timmy. Just wish it wasn't so small.
I finally found it.
What did you find?
The exact location of the Waltons' secret headquarters.
Who are the Waltons?
The superheroes! and I also figured out the mechanics of their capsules.
Cool. Do these capsules give them superpowers?
Until we get our hands on them.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. My name is Nick. Would you like to order?
I'll have a cappuccino.
I'll have a soy latte. And a cookie. Cause I want that. Hey, what do you have in your pocket? Hey. I'm talking to you, kid. I know you find it very funny. The whole thing. You find it very funny. But, you see? Recording people ain't funny. If you like funny stuff, Nick, I'm gonna show you something funny. Get him, Timmy!
Screwed up this time. The mobsters got away. He took my capsule. Who knows what they're gonna do with it? How can I be so stupid?
Anything wrong, mister?
I could tell you, but you wouldn't believe me.
I understand. My name is Abigail, and I've been living on these streets for 6 months now. I hate it. I really do, but sometimes life is just too hard. Me and my family, when they were abducted, I had no choice. I found this curb here, I sat down, and the rest is history.
That's so sad. My problems are minuscule compared to yours. Everything's going to be fine, Abigail. Everything's going to be okay. Headquarters was the first place that came into my mind. If my family still exists.
Stay positive, Nick. Just stay positive.
You be positive. I'll be realistic.
Well, well, well. What do we have here? It's that stupid and miserable Nicky Walton.
It's nice to see you too, Marco.
Say, Nick. I want to ask you a question. And you don't have to answer. But how come and how do you interrupt every one of my crime sprees? Is it your superpowers?
You see,
I don't feel so comfortable, I see. I was a shy kid too. However, those are days when I had to talk to the classroom are over. I now control the entire criminal organization of a paradise city. Of course, I have no choice then. Now, if I don't want to talk to somebody, I just give them a little and they're gone. Poof. So I guess the final question is, how does the cap sort of work?
I'll never tell you.
Fine, I won't ask. But, instead, maybe I'll, light up for your family.
I'll tell you if you promise not to murder my family.
Ah, don't worry. I'm not gonna murder him. I'm just gonna torture him slowly.
All right. I'll tell you.
Fine.
You see, years ago, I got these stupid superpowers. They controlled me, and I couldn't do anything about it. When I felt sad or angry, my powers acted crazy. I felt so bad. But then, I thought of an idea. An insane but wonderful idea. I got all the books I could find on science and math, and read like a bookworm. Eventually, I found a solution. The capsule. The mechanics inside the capsule help create a stable force between my emotions and abilities. Eventually, I figured out something extraordinary. When I met my wife, Julie, I figured out how to implant my powers into her. I knew the world would go crazy if they knew a superpowered being married a non-superpowered being. So I did it, and it worked. The capsules are a modern medical miracle. Nothing can stop them, not cancer, not the flu, nothing. I repeat, nothing can stop it.
I didn't need the drama. Just tell me the ingredients of the capsule, and I'll let your family go.
You don't need to worry, because I'm going to blast you through the wall.
Which one of you two wants to die of first?
Please save us! Save us! We'll do anything!
In myself.
Citizens of Paradise City, this is your mayor speaking. I'm excited to announce our special guests on this fabulous morning. Please join me in welcoming Nicholas, Julie, and Thomas Walton. To Nicholas Walton, I award you the Bravery Medal of this city. Only a select few have worn this medal, and you are one of the lucky few. Everyone, please join me in congratulating Nicholas Walton as I bestow on you the Bravery Medal of this city.
Thank you.
and to you, Julie Walton, the one who fought against the odds against one of the most powerful men in the city, I award you the Fearlessness Medal.
I have something for you, Tom.
The I Did It Award. This certifies that Thomas Walton has done something so pointless, he actually got an award. This is the mayor.
Take a look at my life and realize there's nothing left. Cause I've been blasting and laughing so long that even my mama thinks that my mind is gone. But I ain't never crossed a man that didn't deserve it. Me be treated like a punk, you know that's unheard of. You better watch how you're talking and where you're walking, or you and your homies might get lined and chalk. I really hate to trip, but I gotta low. As they croak, I see myself in the pistol smoke. Fool, I'm the kind of G the little homies wanna be, like on my knees in the night, saying prayers in the street light.